That's a widgeon. In a way, we have the Russians to thank for the fact that we're able to see so much wildlife in these river forelands to the south of Arnhem. The 1950s is sometimes referred to as the Netherlands period of reconstruction. Much was destroyed or lost during the Second World War, and Arnhem was no exception. As a result, there were several plans to build new residential districts, including here in Meinerswijk. But the plans for developing Meinerswijk continually foundered. It was never entirely clear why, but this area was never built on. Of course, we now know that the Ministry of Defence stopped, or you could even say shot down, any plans for new building here. If there were new residential districts, they'd have to evacuate even more people. While the thoughts of the majority of Dutch citizens had turned to freedom and reconstruction during the 1950s, the Ministry of Defence had turned its attention to a new threat, the Red Army. If the Soviet Union were to attack Western Europe, we'd need to delay the Russian advance to the Randstad, the urbanized area in the west of the Netherlands. Here, opposite Meinerswijk, there's still a defense harbor. From there, the lower Rhine could be blocked off with a floating dam so that the water would run into the Esel Valley. In the space of 5 days, a water line would be created that ran from Arnhem to Kampen. A wide stretch of water, too deep for troops and tanks and too shallow for boats. Of course, the strategic points along the waterline needed to be guarded. Allied tanks that had been left over after the war and were still able to fire were encased in concrete and buried. In times of tension, old brickworks along the river were used to accommodate soldiers and hide military supplies. Along the lower Rhine, anti-aircraft guns, searchlight positions, and casemates were all built. The upshot? Instead of houses, they created a military project that left nature to its own devices. The Cold War remained cold. The Russians never came. Here and there you can find the remains of the post-war defences, the Esel Line. And, fortunately, the wildlife remained. I can hear a corncrake.
The Cold War took place in the second half of the 20th century. In the years after the Second World War, capitalist America and the communist Soviet Union found themselves at loggerheads. Tensions were riding high, particularly during the Cuban Missile Crisis of 1962. Both sides threatened a nuclear strike. To slow down a possible Russian attack, top secret plans were made in the Netherlands to flood a large area of land.